Hi, and welcome to the show today. Today we're going to do another edition of my grill smoker series, and we're going to be doing barbecue chicken. I have two large roasting chickens here, whole chickens, and we're going to cut those up. But first I'm going to make my marinade. So I'm going to take one Kraft Tuscan Italian dressing bottle. We're going to use all of that. We're going to use some apple cider vinegar. Use probably a half a cup. We're going to use some Kraft honey barbecue sauce. And again, it's probably going to be a half a cup. Let's go ahead and measure that out. We're going to take some paprika, I guess about a tablespoon. We'll take about a teaspoon of garlic powder and about a teaspoon of onion powder. Take a bottle of this McCormick's Perfect Pinch rotisserie chicken seasoning, and we're going to use that whole bottle in there. Now put a little bit of pepper, guess about a half a teaspoon, and about a half a teaspoon of salt. Now if you want to use, I have some other spices here, if you want to use the McCormick brown sugar bourbon spice, you can. If you want to use the McCormick applewood rub spice, it's pretty good too. And sometimes I use the Asian spicy Szechuan and the Asia spicy sweet and Saigon, sweet and spicy Saigon seasoning. But today, this is my mixture for today. I'm going to go ahead and puree that up. Me a spoon here. Make sure all those spices are mixed up in there. Do that again. All right, that's going to be our marinade for our chicken. Now we're going to go ahead and we're going to cut these chickens up. We're just going to split them down the middle. Okay, what I do is I clean them, I put water in the bag, get it all in there inside, I dump it out, then I wash the chicken really, really well, and I check for cut any excess skin off. And I look for any pen feathers, and I just make sure it's washed really well. Okay, what we're going to do is we're going to take our kitchen pair of scissors here. And we're going to cut down the middle. You know, I don't think scissors are going to cut this one. It's a little too big. So we're just going to slice this bird completely in half. Right down the center. I'm going to cut through that breastbone. You're going to have to push down on it. Now we'll use our scissors to cut through the back. Okay, so there you have it. You have a half of a chicken. You have a couple pin feathers we got to pull off. And then we're going to put this in a pan, in a glass dish. We're going to marinate this for about 4 hours. We have our dish here. I'm going to go ahead and do the other chicken. Go ahead and make sure I clean, make sure there's no pin feathers on it. When we come back, I'm going to show you how to put that marinade on and get that ready to marinate for a couple hours. Okay, as you can see, I removed the backbone of the chicken and the rib bones. So I made a 2 halves here. And what we're going to do is we're going to marinate that right here in these dishes. We're going to let that marinate for about 4 hours. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and pour our marinade all over this chicken. Put the other one in there. You want to get it all over. You want to get that chicken soaked in that marinade. Now remember, when you're dealing with raw chicken, when you're done, you have to clean up your work area really well before you prepare any other foods. So there's one there. And we'll move that one around in a sec. Make sure it's coated really good. And it'll take all of this. Also remember not to use any of this residual marinade after you start cooking your chicken, because you don't want to contaminate your cooked chicken with raw chicken juices. So we'll slide that one aside. Wash my hands again. And we're going to put the rest of this marinade all over the other . And it doesn't really matter if you marinate them upside down, but after a couple hours, if you want to flip them, this first bird is twice the size of the second bird. So get that all in there. Alright, so we're going to cover these with plastic wrap and we're going to slip them in the fridge for about 4 hours.
I'm going to gather up some hickory and some applewood for my smoker. these trees here are chestnut. That's a big oak tree over there. There was a maple tree in the front of the house that we cut. And all that brush from that maple tree was just like that. But it was a maple tree. It was in the front yard. And there it is down there. And that pile just has to be cut up for firewood or burned. Anyway, this is the chestnut trees. We got some hickory right here. So we're going to get it. Looks like there's some already down, so I don't have to cut any, I don't think. Yeah, here's plenty of hickory on the ground. Of course, we'll probably take this one. Oh, didn't even have to do that. Whole thing broke off. So there's our hickory. We're gonna walk down here. Put this right here. We're gonna walk down here and we're gonna get some apple wood. I have 3 apple trees here. And back behind there, I've got a bunch more hickories. And then that tree and that tree are walnut. So we're gonna grab a little bit of apple wood. A little apples on there. So we're not gonna grab much. Grab a couple sprigs. I was looking for something a little bit bigger, but I don't see why. Chair's a nice one. Go ahead and take that one too. While I'm down here, check out the water we had fixed this year. There's Mildred with her little baby. They at the watering trough. If you see any of those little tree moss that grows on it, go ahead and take that off because you don't want to burn that. It kind of grows on apple wood. And I don't burn that. Let's see how. See what I mean? So I got maple, got a stick of maple out there, got some hickory, a stick of hickory, and I got this apple wood. And then that's going to be the smoke for our chickens. So I'm going to bring this on out here. Yeah, I'm going to go get the other camera so I can set it up on the tripod.
Okay, we're going to set this grill up for smoking those chickens. But we're going to mainly grill those chickens. So, we're going to put a nice sized portion of charcoal in the main. And we're going to put some over here for our smoking our wood. I'm not going to do much on that side because I don't want my chickens too heavily smoked. I just want them to have a hint of a smoke flavor. So, put a couple more over there out of here. Okay, so there's, we'll take this off this tripod a sec. There's what I got in there. And I'm going to start that, and then I'm going to put my
sprig of hickory, a sprig of maple, and my couple branches of applewood in there. And then I'm gonna stack this up in here to grill, to finish cooking those four pieces of chicken. There are two large chickens that are cut in half that we're gonna be smoking and grilling today. Okay, I got this stacked up, and I'm using Kingsford charcoal here, using the original Kingsford charcoal. And today I've done something that I normally don't do, so I'm giving it a shot. Is I got this Kingsford odorless charcoal lighter, and today I put some on my charcoal. I very, very seldom use charcoal lighter. I usually start my coals in that chimney, the handheld chimney there with the propane torch. But the propane torch is at the turkey barns today, and I just didn't feel like going up to get it. So I'm going to go ahead and close this door here. I'm going to leave that open a little bit. I'm going to close this lid, and then that should draw and start those coals up pretty nicely. There's all my wood here. So I'm gonna go ahead and close these lids up. If we come back about 15 minutes, 20 minutes, it should be ready to go.
Okay, while I was waiting for this charcoal to light, I went ahead and soaked my wood in some water, and I'm gonna put it on in just a couple seconds. So it seems like it's doing pretty well there. So we're gonna go ahead and put our wood on, and then we're going to spread out these charcoals up here because they're pretty well good too. We're going to spread those out. We're going to go ahead and put our chicken on. Now I'm going to cook this chicken for about 4 hours, so it's going to be good and done. Okay, this smoker is up to about 250. We're going to go ahead and chickens have been marinating for almost 4.5 hours. So we're going to go ahead and put them on. Now remember, don't use this marinade after you take these chickens out. We're going to put some Kraft honey barbecue sauce on them once they get half cooked. That's that big one. This one's huge. Okay, the smoker's going pretty good. It's been about, 15 minutes. So we're just gonna look in here. Temperature's up about 265. It's going to be doing pretty good. Now that temperature, as those coals, all of them get caught, that temperature will climb to about 325, and that'll be in about 45 minutes from now. And that hickory, maple, and applewood smoke, show you what that looks like.
Now I'm not gonna, I did soak it a little bit, but I want it, that big piece is soaked pretty well, and so is the small. It's not burning up too much. It'll probably take an hour and a half to go through that. That'll give that chicken just a hint of apple, maple, and hickory. Okay, it's been about 25 minutes, and as you can see, that temperature is up to about 275 right now. So it's right now still in the smoking section. At the smoking section. It's still in the smoking section of the thermometer. And so when we get up there about 325, that's when you're barbecuing and roasting. So it'll stay about 275 for another 25 minutes or so. I'm making the sauce for the barbecue chicken. This is after it's been marinated and the chicken's on the grill. So I'm going to use about a quarter of a cup of vinegar. I'm going to use probably a cup of the Kraft Honey barbecue sauce. Now put a little salt and pepper and a little paprika in there. Now I'm going to stir that up. You know, I think I need a whisk. You know what? I'm going to put it in a deeper bowl, too. So I'm going to end up splashing that everywhere. So that's going to be my sauce that I'm going to be putting on my barbecue chicken. Well, I guess it's a half hour, maybe 45 minutes on the grill here. I turned them over. We're going to put some of this sauce mixture I made. And again, I took some Kraft Honey Barbecue, about a cup of Kraft Honey Barbecue. I took some salt and pepper, some paprika, and a quarter of a cup of vinegar. And I whisk it in the bowl here. And that's what I'm going to coat this chicken with. Because you don't want to use that marinade that you've already marinated the birds in. I'm going to move these over off of the heat right now. This one didn't get quite as brown, so we'll leave that one closer to it. Scoot those over so they have time to roast. About an hour, 10 minutes or so. I'm going to coat these again. Backside of that. It's doing well. We're not going to flip the others yet. Move that little bird over there. Alright, so we'll come back in another 20 minutes or so. Okay, it's been about an hour and a half. These birds are coming along great. Saw some more sauce on them. Check the underside. I got them a little off the side of the heat. When we go to pull them off, we're gonna check the internal temperature. go ahead and coat a little bit more sauce. All right, the temperature was up to 400 before I opened that lid. There's my wood. See, it's still hour and a half. It's still going. I soaked that in a little bit of water, so climbing back up to 350. It only has to have the lid closed for a second to come back up to temperature. Okay, it's been an hour and 45 minutes. We're going to check the internal temperature. So you go to the meat, you gotta get a chicken, and we want to go Fahrenheit. So our target temp is 175 degrees. So we turn this bottom receiver on here, transmitter. We're gonna go ahead and stick one of the biggest ones. And see what it comes up to. It's up to 128 now. 137. 143. 45. 49. 151, 153, 54. That's the largest of the pieces and the thickest part. 155. It's still climbing. I wanted at least 175, 180. I think it pretty much stopped at 157 there. So we got a little ways to go. Still climbing a little bit. All right, so we're going to sauce these back up again. We're going to check them about 2.5 hours. So it'll be about another 25 minutes or so. Check the back sides of this little one here. Turn him over just a tiny bit. Ooh, it's hot in there. Okay, we're gonna look at that, it's just falling apart already. Now when I finish these towards the end, I'm gonna be wrapping this in some tinfoil and letting it sit in here. So those larger pieces over here closer to that fire. We're just gonna have to keep an eye on them. Alright, we'll come back about a half hour. We're about 2.5 hours. Temperature's about 360. These birds are looking nice. Make sure they're not burning or anything. Those two pieces don't come apart. Lost a little piece in there too. And we're going to check the temperature inside. Stick this big one here. Gotta go to chicken. Meat. There's chicken. I go to Fahrenheit. Okay. It's 163,
66, 68, 70, 72, 73, come on, hit the magic number. 74, one more, 174, there we go, so we're right on target, it's about right at almost 3 hours, but you're cooking it low and slow. I'm not on top of those coals there. As you can see, they're pretty warm. Little Miss Connie's still mowing. Actually, before we go, look at old Mildred up there. Mildred and her little baby. All the other sheep at the other end of the pasture, and so's the cows. It's 8 o'clock in Highland County, Virginia. There's the two buck sheep too. They're getting ready to go in with the girls here in about a week or so. Okay, we're right at 3.5 hours. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and wrap this stuff up. That chicken's definitely done. Wrap this up, pull the sides in. I'm gonna pop that thing right in there in the corner until we're ready for dinner. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and try one. Let me go get a knife. Yep, that's all right. Wait a minute here. I see what I've done. I wrapped up two. That's right. Oh, I see. This is missing the leg. All right. We'll get going and get the knife. We're going to try that right here. Look at that. It's got a little bit of a smoke ring. Oh, man. You know something? That, my friends. This barbecue chicken. That, the piece of this breast off of here. Ooh, it's hot. I have to remember this is my piece. That, my friends. There's chicken. Grilled. Look at this wing. Woo! On a smoker. Ow! Let's take a bite out of that. Oh, that puppy's hot. Look at that. Tom's Manly Mills Grill and Smoking Series. That's barbecue chicken right there.
Let me get these others off of here. I'm talking Tom Moore. And good luck to you. Look at that. Good luck to you. Look at that. Mmm. It's a nice bark. That, my friends, is barbecue chicken. Well, until next time, for Tom's Manly Meals, good luck to you. Got them puppies in there until it's time to serve. So, that charcoal, you can tell, that charcoal lasted 3.5 hours. It's still going strong. So that's about a 4-hour burn on that that amount of charcoal. And the smoke section on there, as you can see, it's all but gone. I guess that was like 20 briquettes, but